Hi, thanks for joining me. This is Angie at ChicnScratch, and today we're making a butterfly quilt. This quilt is 7 blocks across, 8 blocks down, for a total of 56 blocks. I'm using pre-cuts to make this quilt, and we're going to be using a layer cake, actually two of them. You get 40 10-inch blocks in a layer cake, so that's why you need two of them, but you won't need all of the second one. Okay, now for the butterflies, I'm using a charm pack. You're going to need two of those that are matching. Now, I'm going to tell you that these charm packs are about 5 or 6 years old. They're probably not available any longer. They are beautiful, but they're probably not out there in the stores. Okay, so to cut the butterflies, we're going to be using the AccuQuilt machine with the Critters die, and we're going to be using the butterfly. This die does have a couple other critters on there, but we're using the butterfly. Okay, so now we're using the butterfly. I'm going to take 4 pieces of fabric. I want to make sure that they're all lined up because, to be honest, they barely fit on that butterfly. Then once I get them all straight, I'm going to add a cutting pad on top. And then on top of the cutting pad, I'm going to add a piece of cardstock. This serves as a shim. I'm going to turn it around and start it on the end where there's no fabric. That just makes it a little easier to roll through the machine. Because we have 4 pieces of fabric and not one, it's a little harder to roll. And if you wanted, you could do 2 at a time or even 1. I like getting a bunch done. Okay, so the next step is you're going to lift up the cutting pad. Make sure you do not pull these threads. Because I only rolled it through once, you want to just snip those little ends right there. Don't pull it. You're going to mess up your butterflies if you pull it. Okay, so I'm just going to use my little snippers right here. I love those things. Okay, so if you roll the machine or if you roll the die through 2 times, oftentimes you won't have to snip the threads. So I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to place 4 pieces of fabric on top, again, making sure that they're straight. Then I'm going to add a cutting pad, a piece of cardstock, turn it around and start it at the end that does not have fabric. And now I'm going to roll it through. And then right before I get to the end, I'm going to back it up and then roll it back through again. So you're going to see that. So roll through, and then at some point, so now I reverse it, and then I go back through. And that just takes care of those little pieces that needed to be trimmed. See? Perfect. Okay, I've cut out all 56 butterflies, and the next step is I want to make sure that I attach my butterflies to the fabric correctly. We're talking about the grain of fabric. So what I'm going to do is snap both sides. You're going to see it's me snapping right here. I'm testing which one's going to be the loudest or which one has the less give or less stretch. So see how stretchy that is? I want to attach my butterflies facing up on the side that does not stretch. So you just saw that. I'm going to place the butterfly right on top just like that. I'm going to use our Stampin' Up! Glue sticks, and I'm going to apply the glue on the back side. This is so easy. And what this does is it gluing down the butterflies keeps them in place when you're sewing around each of them, because the next step after we sew or after we glue down all 56 butterflies is then we're going to sew around each one of them. So this glue really helps to keep the butterflies in place. Okay, so now we're going to sew around the butterflies. I'm going to stitch around every single butterfly, and I promise it doesn't take as long as you think. So I'm placing it here on my sewing machine. I'm using foot number 20. I want to make sure my needle is down because I'm going to be turning around this butterfly, and you want to have your needle down. Okay, so I'm just going to stitch around. I am using my knee lift, so I'm raising up that foot with my knee as I'm turning. You're not seeing my hand because I'm using the knee lift. I tell everyone I could not have a sewing machine without a knee lift. So this is going to take a little while because it's going to take me a minute. I'm going slow because I'm filming. While I'm sewing, I'll go ahead and tell you that the edges of the butterflies are going to be what's called raw. And once you wash your quilt, it's going to be a little fluffy or fuzzy or whatever you want to call it. I guess the correct term is raw. But you've seen pictures of my quilts. I'll make sure that there's pictures on my website when I post this video. I love that look, and I've made tons of these because they turn out so beautiful. Okay, so I've got about half of the butterfly stitched. I could fast forward it, but I'm really not going to. Sorry. And I'm going super slow because I'm filming. I have the need to talk through the silence, but I want to say it takes me about 2 minutes per butterfly. So if you've got 56 butterflies and you've got 2 minutes per butterfly, then that is kind of an estimate of how long it's going to actually take to sew around all 56 butterflies. I'm almost there. Now, I have also made flower quilts. Stampin' Up! Used to have a flower die in our catalog, and I started out making flower quilts. We no longer carry that die, and then I found the butterfly die, which everyone seems to love as well, but I am itching to make another flower. Okay, so here we are at the very end. I just want to make sure that I go over those previous stitches just a little bit. So I'm going to go ahead and lift my needle up and remove it. And here it is. So what I'm going to do now is go sew the rest of the butterflies and I'll be back. Thanks. Okay, so here's my butterflies. I have sewn around all 56 of them. And now you can see the stitch line around it. Let me show it to you. See? Okay, so the next step is we're going to take our scissors and we're going to snip all the threads. And we're going to do this on the front of the block. And then we're also going to do it on the back side. And while you're looking at the back side, go ahead and look for any knots that you have. If you have them, go ahead and get your seam rippers and fix them, okay? So you want to make sure that you get rid of all the unnecessary thread before the next step or before you take it to your long arm quilter, okay? Okay, so the next step is deciding where you want your blocks to go. Again, this quilt is 7 blocks across, 8 blocks down for a total of 56. I've placed my blocks on my design wall and I'm ready to start sewing. So my design wall is a piece of sturdy board that measures 40 by 60, and I've covered it with a vinyl tablecloth and attached it with binder clips. So now I'm ready to start sewing my blocks together, and I will start with row 1. Okay, so I've got row 1, and I'm going to attach block 2 to block 1 with the right sides facing together, and then I'm going to pin them. So here is block 2 facing block 1. And then I'm going to get my pins. Now, some people like to pin a little. Some people don't pin at all. I actually pin a lot. In my defense, I get interrupted a lot. So I think by pinning a lot, it helps. So I have attached the first block or the second block to the first block. And I'm going to take this over to my machine. And I'm going to sew a 1/4 inch seam all the way down the right side. And make sure you backstitch also. Now before I do that, I'm going to go ahead and attach block 3 to block 2 and pin it. And then I'm going to keep going down the row. So I'm going to attach block 4 to block 3, block 5 to block 4. So I'll show you a couple of those. So right now I'm attaching block 3 to block 2. I'm going to pin it 3 3 times at the top, the bottom, and in the middle. I've found that the more I pin, the straighter my seams are. I'm getting better at it. So now I'm attaching block 4 to block 3. And I'm not going to make you watch me do the whole row. It's the exact same process all the way to the end. So I'll go ahead and stop here. Okay, so I've got my entire row pinned together. And now it's time to sew my blocks together. So this is row number 1. I have been using foot number 20. I'm going to change that out to use foot number 57. This has a 1/4 inch seam guide on the right side, and that just helps me keep my seam perfect. Okay, so I'm taking off 20, putting on 57. Okay, so I'm going to put my pin cushion here, and then just remove my first pin. I'm going to keep my needle down. I like keeping my needle down just in case I move or something. And then I am going to backstitch. So I'm just going to stitch a couple and then backstitch. If my fabric is going to shift, it usually always happens here towards the end. Now I'm going to backstitch. Okay, so I'm going to do one more, and then I won't make you watch me do all of them because they all pretty much work the exact same way. So I will sew this one, and then I'll get all of them done, and then I'll show you the next step. Again, back stitch. Okay, so I have sewn all the blocks together, and now I want to check for threads, and I want to trim all of those. You want to make sure before you take your quilt to your long arm quilter that you trim all those extra threads. So I'm going to go over the entire row, and I've already attached all my blocks, so I'm going to take each row and I'm going to snip the threads, and then as soon as I'm done snipping the threads, I'm going to press the seams. So this is just going to take me a minute. I probably should have fast-forwarded through part of this. One more. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is turn it over, and I'm going to get my iron, and I'm going to press the seams. At the same time, I'm going to iron the block a little bit, and I use a lot of steam. I do have a different iron than what I've used in the past, so you haven't seen me use this one yet, but I do love it. And what I want to do is alternate my seams. So this first row, I'm going to press my seams to the right. Then the second row, I'm going to press my seams to the left. So that way when I go to attach my rows to each other, the seams are going to be alternating, okay? So I'm going to turn this over and get my iron. And I'm sorry, my video is a little shaky. I did use my iPhone to film this entire video. So my tripod was shaking a little bit. Again, I'm using my steam, and I'm just going to do this entire row, and then when I'm done with row 1, I will press row 2, and then so on until I get to the very end. So I'm going to go ahead and stop it now, and I'll be back when I'm done ironing. Okay, so I've pressed all my rows, and I'm ready to attach row 2 to row 1, and then so on, and pin them. So I've placed a pin in this upper left corner. I always do this on my quilts. That just reminds me that that's my upper left corner of my quilt. And so what I'm going to do is line up my seams, and I'm going to actually start in the middle. So I'm going to flip this over, line these up, and then I'm going to go to the very middle and start pinning in the middle and then work my way out to the right. And again, I want to say I'm sorry that the video is a little shaky. I'm using my iPhone and it's on a tripod, and I just did not realize how much the table was shaking until after I'd already filmed all the videos. So sorry about that. Okay, so right here I attach the seam, or I'm putting the seams together, making sure they line up properly. And now you can see why I chose row 1 to go to the right and row 2 to go to the left. That just helps line up your seam. So then I'm just going to work out to the right. Again, I do pin a lot, so I'm going to place a pin in the middle, and then I'm going to move over to the right seam and then pin again. And I'm going to go all the way down to the right side, and then I'm going to move back over to the left, because if you'll remember, I started in the middle. So I'm going to finish this out, and then I'll show you going back to the left side, but then I won't make you watch all of it. So what I'll do is pin row 2 to row 1, and then I'll take it to the sewing machine and sew it. And then I'll attach 3 to 2, pin it, and then sew it. I don't pin the entire quilt. So see, now I'm going back to the left. Now, I'll stop here. You don't have to watch me pin. I think you've seen enough of that. Okay, so I've got row 2 pinned to row 1, and now we're ready to sew. I'm going to place it on my sewing machine and line up the right side with the foot with the quarter inch seam guide. So I'm just going to bring in my machine and we'll get started. Okay, so again, I'm starting right here in the left corner. I place it here. I've got my foot 57, needle down. Okay, I'm going to backstitch. Now, I like to stop often to make sure that everything is straight. Okay, so we have got row 1 sewn to row 2, and now we'll sew row 3 to row 2. So when I get all the rows sewn, I'll show you the quilt top. Okay guys, so I have sewn all of my rows together. I can take out that pin in my upper left corner. I no longer need that. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to snip all the extra threads. I want to make sure that when I take it to the long arm quilter that it doesn't have any extra threads on it. So I'll just trim all of those. I'm also going to look for any holes that may be in here. Even though I've already looked for them, I'm going to look again. And then I'm going to turn it over and I'm going to press the seams. I am not going to film that because you've already seen me iron, and there's no need to show you that step, but I will iron and starch the entire thing. Now, after I trim the threads and I press it and look for holes, then we need to measure it to figure out how much batting and backing fabric, and I don't know if I need to get that back out again. I use the binder clip to keep my tape measure. So what I'm going to do is start on the upper left corner, and I'm going to measure it. So place this at the end, and then I'm going to go all the way across. I went 7 blocks across and 8 blocks down, and this measures right at 68. So I'm going to write down on my piece of paper 68, and then I want to measure the length of it. So that's the width. So now the width, or the length, I'm sorry, that was the width, this is the length. Okay, and it's right at 80 inches. So I'm going to write that down. So it's 68 by 80. Now I'm going to show you a wonderful tool that I use. Okay, guys, so I have this wonderful app that's going to show you how to determine how much backing fabric and binding fabric you need. So I'm going to click on the quilting calculator. It's for the iPad or the iPhone. I'm going to skip the ad. And then I'm going to come up here and I'm going to click on backing and batting. So you want to buy the same amount. The width of the fabric is 43 inches. The width of my fabric, my quilt top, is 68 inches. The length was 80 inches. I want 2 inches for the overage. And then if you come down here now, it says that I need 4 3/4 yards of fabric. Not inches, but yards. You need 171 inches, but that's 4 3/4. So that's backing fabric and your batting. Now my long arm quilter provides the batting, so I only have to buy the backing fabric. Now I want to figure out how much fabric I need for the binding. So I'm going to click on binding. And I have a very small binding. My long arm quilter does it for me. So I have 2 inches. I'm going to enter in the same measurements of my quilt top, so that's 68 by 80, and she does the bias binding, so I'm going to click on bias, and that shows that I need a half a yard of fabric for the binding. So I'm going to go to the fabric store, buy 4 3/4 yards of backing fabric and a half a yard of binding fabric. Okay, so that wraps up the butterfly quilt top, and next I'm going to take it to the long arm quilter, and I'll be sure to post a picture when it's ready. Thanks a lot. Bye.